Hey, Jason Burrell here. In this video, I want to demonstrate how to create pie charts. Not just how to create them, but go beyond the basics, go a little bit deeper and show you some of the tricks, some of the things that people generally don't know about that will help you to improve your presentation. Pie charts are a very effective way of showing the proportion of each value against a total. Here's how to do one. The first thing I'm going to do, as with any chart, is to select the data I want to use on the chart. So in this case, I'm going to choose my list of names down here in column A. I'm going to hold control and select 1 year's worth of figures, the 2018 figures. Holding down control lets you select two completely different ranges at the same time. And the reason I've only chosen one column is because pie charts only work with a single range of data. So a single column of figures or a single row of figures. It won't work. There's no way to do it on two-dimensional data. With that data selected, I could press F11, but that always produces a column chart as a starting point. And of course, from there, you could switch it over to a pie chart if you wanted. What I'm going to do instead is to go to the Insert tab, go to my Charts Gallery and find the pie. And there's a number of different pie options you can choose from. Just for this demonstration, I'm going to choose the 3D pie. When the chart is first produced, you might think, okay, that looks okay. But actually, even though it's functional, it's not actually presented that well at all. Because you've got your pie here with its different colours, but the legend representing the colours is actually separated from the chart. It's listed underneath. You know, you've got to look at the label, you've got to connect the colour with the slice on the pie, and it's extra work that you don't really need. Now at the top here, under Chart Tools and the Design tab, you have a number of preset options that you can use if you wanted to. So each of these options presents the data in different ways. So some reposition the legend, others place labels on the chart in different positions, and you might find that one of these options is actually okay. Now I've just had a quick skim through and I can't really see anything that's presenting the data properly. What I really want is something that shows the person's name, their net worth, and a percentage against the total. And there's none of those options that really do that. So I'm going to customize this and I want to show you how I'm going to do this. Let me just close this for a second. Because I went through the Insert tab, when I produce the chart, it always appears as an object in the current sheet. The first thing I'm going to do is to put it on its own sheet. So under Chart Tools here, Design tab, I'm going to go to Move Chart here. And the two options, as we saw before, are to put the chart on a brand new sheet and give it a name, or where it currently is, an object in the current sheet. So let's just put it into a new sheet and let's just call it Pie. So now you've got a chart on its own sheet called Pie and it's full size. So it's a lot easier to work with. I'm then going to go to the plus sign here to show the different chart elements. A pie chart only has three, so it's a lot less than something like a column chart, because there's less elements to deal with. For this demonstration, I'm going to firstly switch off the legend. Okay, the legend serves no purpose here. And also, just for simplicity, I'm going to switch off the chart title as well. My main work will be with the data labels. Now, I could tick it, and as you can see from the preview, it would add the data values onto the pie. I can also click the little arrow here to have my choice of position. So you can see center puts it in a center of each pie slice. Inside end, outside end, best fit. For best fit, some are inside and some are outside. Or data callout. Now data callout is actually probably the closest to what I really want. That is the person's name. You've got the percentage there. I also want to show the net worth value. If I go to more options, I like this option because it gives you a separate side panel with everything you need. Everything's in one place. The default settings, as you can see, it's put some of the labels inside, one of them outside. So for consistency, the first thing I'm going to do is to come down to the bottom of this list of options. And instead of choosing best fit, I'm going to specifically say I want them all outside end. So all the labels are outside. In terms of what I'm showing, that's what this first section does, label contains. So value is what's currently on the pie. I'm also going to add category name, which is the person that the value belongs to, and also percentage. So now I've got all three of those elements that I wanted at the beginning. Person's name, value, percentage. There's also this thing here called leader lines, which I'll explain in just a second. So even if we didn't take it any further, this is now a much more functional pie because it shows you the information you need. So what kind of things can you do from this point? Well, firstly, let's address the issue of labels. Sometimes, depending on what sort of chart you're working on, the labels will overlap. In particular, when a pie has lots of really thin slices, so small percentages and all next to each other, you'll find that the labels will overlap quite commonly. So what you can do is this. If you click on any given label, all the labels initially will be selected. But if you click on a label again, it isolates it so that just that one is selected. And when that one is selected, if you hover over and get your four-headed arrow, you can then click and drag away from the pie slice, and it connects to its slice with this thing called a leader line. So you can never disconnect the label from its appropriate slice. It always stays connected with this leader line. If we did one or two others, so here I click this next label, let's move that out a bit as well. And maybe this one as well. Let's maybe move that out. So we've now separated all of those slices and hopefully it'll present better. Now something else you can do with a pie is to explode it. And exploding just means separating your slices. So the easiest way to do this is to hover over any slice and in one movement, click and drag away from the center. And what happens is every slice separates from the other. If you want to put the pie back together again, the danger is if you just click and drag a slice back to the middle, it just moves that one slice back. Now, the reason for that is that if I just click outside here so that nothing's selected, the first click on a slice, you'll notice selects every slice. The second click on a slice isolates it so that just that one slice is selected. And that's what we saw just a minute ago. So when we clicked and dragged away from the center in one move, that's actually working with the whole pie. The second time we did it though, it actually put the focus on the one slice. To get the chart back together again quickly, if I click outside the pie to deselect all the slices, and then again in one movement, if I hover over one slice and click and drag it towards the middle, it's working with every slice on the pie and it collapses, puts the pie back together again. If you want to extract one slice, at the moment, every slice has the focus. If I click on the slice I want to extract, let's say this one, just that one slice now has the focus, which means if I click and drag it away from the center, just that one slice moves. When you have a presentation and one slice is extracted like this, it brings the focus in. People concentrate on that slice and it allows you to talk about it and discuss it, and people know exactly which bit you're talking about. Let's just move that back to the middle again. Let's say I extract Bill Gates from the rest of the pie. Now, while it's extracted, it's doing its job, but it actually presents a lot better if that's front and center. If Bill Gates was at the front of the pie, it looks better. So if we come across to the side panel here and click this little icon that looks like a column chart, it's called Series Options. It gives you a slider called Angle of First Slice. And you can either type in a number of degrees here, or you can drag this slider left or right to increase the angle. Now I'm just going to take a guess here, maybe 160 degrees or something. Yeah, that's close. See how it's kind of brought it roughly front and center. So now if I make some minor adjustments, I can make it exactly front and center. And there we go, 158 degrees. That's about right. So in a presentation, there may be a few key slices or key people you want to talk about. If you replicate the chart a few times, and on each chart, just extract the slice that you want to talk about, it just helps you focus on the one thing. So there's a few things you can do with pie charts. Go and have a play.